I have too many buttons on these controllers, kids. You know what I mean? Okay, we have robots. We have lizards. Oh my God, we have unique experiments. We love STEM, and you kids love STEM too, yes?
Yes.
Say yes, we love, okay.
Yes, this is we awesome. Love STEM. Yes, we love STEM.
Science!
We have a whole lot of science on the Fox 5 backlog, Magnolia Science Academy, Mad Science, Eco Vivarium, Reptile Sanctuary. You are all here this morning. Good morning to all of you, and thank you for being here.
Oh man, this is cool. Okay, we have Jay Perez. Magnolia Science Academy, you're an eighth grade math teacher.
Correct.
Thank you for the job you do, because that's a tough gig. That's a great age, right, kids? Middle school, isn't that great? Yeah. My daughter's in eighth grade, so I understand. Tell me about, this is amazing. You have like VEX robotics. I don't know what that is. What is that?
So it's a snap-on design. Kids will build it pretty much from the ground up. It's all on their heads, and they gotta bring it to life. They gotta code it using either Scratch program or a Python program.
These kids built that?
Those kids built this. Exactly.
You did not do that.
We did.
No. I don't believe you.
We did.
Well, you say they have to imagine it in their heads first. So y'all imagine that?
Yep.
Get out of here. Right? Listen, man. In terms of what is the purpose of it? Because these aren't like the fighting robots.
No, they're not.
These are like with a purpose and to do some kind of work? Or how does that, what do you tell them in terms of when they're coming up with the idea?
Right, so every year is a new challenge.
Okay.
This year is called Full Volume.
Yeah.
The topic or the object about this one is to pick up the cubes and put them into the scoring zone.
Oh, whoa.
Which the kids will demonstrate.
Can you
in a
kids
bit.
Turn it on and listen, show the camera your controllers, first of all, please, because I can, you know, back in my day, we had Atari 2600. You know what that had? It had one joystick. Kids, I had one button. You kids are spoiled. You have 12 buttons on your controllers. Okay, are we ready to go? We turn these on, and now what are we going to be doing? We're going to be picking up cubes and moving them. Ready? Go!
Oh,
stop
cool.
it. Get out of here. Get what? How the... Oh, hey, you threw yours back,
yeah.
And you kind of have a little thing to get, and then you have a thing that it goes up like an elevator, and it holds them in the back thing there. Oh, I like that part, and then you dump them.
And then you dump them.
That looks cool. Can I try to do yours real quick? Wait, do we have to go to Charlie now?
Yes, you do have to
go to
Charlie.
I don't want to. Which is the one that goes pick up the button? Pick up. Okay, pick up. Oh, okay, ready? Here we go. How am I doing, kids?
Why are you playing with that?
Oh, get that last one, kids. Oh, Nelly. Oh, I'm going backwards. What am I doing? Jay, how am I doing?
Great.
You guys don't call him Jay, though, right? What do you call him, Mr. Perez?
Yep, Mr. Perez.
Very respectful. I like that. Kids, respect will get you everywhere. Okay, let's get you over to Shali.
No, look at
what we have. Miss Zomarodi.
I'm Miss Zomarodi today. Is that what I am? Look at this, Radical Rob.
Hey.
Mad Science. Oh, you got something cool going on here.
We absolutely do.
What is that?
Right over here, we have some dry ice, which is frozen carbon dioxide gas. And then we have some hot water bubbling through it. And what happens is this dry ice will turn into gas. It'll sublimate through the hot water, and that's why all of this vapor comes out. It's one of the really fun things that we experiment with it.
Okay, I got to come over here because I see these two young scientists like bouncing around. You're so excited and fascinated. Does that make you happy to see that?
Yeah.
Why?
Yeah. Because it looks cool and it's fun to do.
It's fun to do, huh? And what are they learning when they do these type of experiments?
Well, they're learning about different states of matter. They're learning about how these different states can go through changes, whether it's a chemical reaction or a physical reaction here. And yeah, they're learning about elements that are not found on the planet Earth, like dry ice. It doesn't naturally exist on the planet Earth.
Okay.
It's been found on the polar ice caps of Mars.
Yeah.
But yeah.
That will explain his face.
Absolutely.
Like the face with the mouth open the entire time. Thank you for being here. That face that you have is exactly the face that I would have if I was standing next to what Raul is standing right now. I'm going to keep that face because I'm not coming there. That's
Come
all
on
you.
Now.
That's all you.
This thing's super
Anything
cool.
with a tongue that long,
super
I
cool.
shall not be
Look,
close
watch
to.
Watch this. You want me to get
No,
watch.
No.
Come here,
Do
sweetheart.
Not.
Come here.
Raul, you're not supposed to touch it.
Oh, yes, sweetheart.
Are you out of your mind?
You're a good boy.
He's
Here, licky,
sweet.
Licky,
licky. He's sweet.
Hey, picky, picky,
He's
picky,
a good
picky,
boy.
Picky, 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 picky. Good boy. That was awesome. Oh, sorry, I'm so distracted. Susan Nowicki, did I get your name right?
Yes, you did.
With Ecovivarium Reptile Sanctuary. This is the thing that we want to... Don't misunderstand these beautiful creatures,
no,
right? Tell me about this
don't.
Beautiful thing. Wow.
Mac is a Salvatore water monitor.
Oh.
He is from Southeast Asia. He's actually stunted. These guys can grow up to 8 to 9 feet in length. And they're amazingly intelligent creatures like all reptiles.
Right, right.
And they have emotions like all reptiles. Uh-huh. So the kids are
so he enjoyed
are
my friendly.
Yeah.
See what I mean?
He loves interaction. He loves cuddles.
Yeah.
The kids, when they come by, are going to get to interact with all the animals from Eco. And they're going to get to learn how they connect with our life.
Tell me about the tongue, because when he was kind of licking my hand, what does that tongue do
and
for him?
Is amazing. They use their tongue to smell. They will pick up scents in the air. They will touch a Jacobson organ at the roof of their mouth. And from that, they can identify where they are, what's around them, and if you're food or not. So long as you don't smell like chicken or
you're good.
Like chicken.
She ate chicken earlier.
So I ate chicken. So can we tell everybody at home, if you want to be a part of this and get in and all the action, why are you getting Sean? Let me come over here. I'm just standing here reading ST Festival Science and Engineering Empower the Next Generation of STEAM Visionaries. It's happening tomorrow at 11 to 5 at Snapdragon Stadium for all the information.
Snapdragon. Get it.
FoxlightSanDiego.com. Click the little seat on time. Your tongue is very long.
What a cool
creature. It's very,
creature.
Very long.
Oh, my God. I love it. Susan, this is so cool.
Thank you.
He looked at me.
But he's friendly. Don't scare. Okay, we'll be right back. Charlie's running away. Good boy.